What is happening, everybody? Lance Cassidy here, and it is time once again for a brand new Let's Play. And if you've been following this channel for a long time, you're probably thinking to yourself, Lance, you've already done Perfect Dark before, haven't you? And the answer to your question is, yes, indeed I have. But considering that was so long ago, and quite obviously the overall quality of my output has greatly improved since then, seriously, I think when I was doing that original Let's Play, I was recording with the MuPen Plus emulator. No face cam at all. I was recording with Fraps and editing with Pinnacle Video Spin. So yeah, I've come a long, long way since that time. And considering this channel is now somewhat of a polished turd rather than just a stinky one, and because Perfect Dark takes place in 2023, and it is still in 2023 as I record this, what better time than now to revisit the game? So we're just going to jump right into things with the first mission, Datadyne Central Defection. And yes, we're going to play on Perfect Agent. Kind of feel like I shortchanged you all when I did The World Is Not Enough on medium difficulty, but even though I will struggle at times, we can definitely get this done. Here we go. Primary objectives: disable internal security hub, obtain key code necklace, download project files, disable external comms hub, gain entrance to laboratory. A Datadyne scientist calling himself Dr. Carroll has contacted the Carrington Institute requesting that we rescue him from the Datadyne headquarters tonight. He claims that he has complained to Datadyne about the moral implications of his current project, but rather than dismiss him, they will mentally restructure him until he finds the nature of the project acceptable again. This is your first mission, Joanna, and it could hardly be more vital to us. We need to get Dr. Carroll out of there before anything happens to him, and we also need to know about Datadyne's future plans. Our standard rules of engagement apply. Do not kill unarmed civilians. Remember, the code keys only work if their owners are alive. The internal security comms hub is located in one of the top floors of the building, away from ground traffic interference. Use an ECM mine to jam the hub and black out the security cameras. The mine must be attached to the hub to be effective. Be quick though, as the mine will only last for about a minute or so. Cassandra DeVries carries her access key for the restricted areas of the building on her necklace. It is linked to her personal health monitor and will cease to be active if her life signs fail. If you take the necklace slash key from her, you must render her unconscious, not kill her. Dr. Carroll's future is being decided in a meeting on one of the office floors. The executive in charge of Dr. Carroll's project is present at the meeting. Follow him to his office and gain access to his project files, then download them to us using your data uplink device. Complete the communication blackout by placing another ECM mine on the equipment in the security room at the base of the building. This will jam any automatic calls for outside help. Finally, locate the secure lift to the basement laboratory where Dr. Carroll is incarcerated. The exact location is unknown, but it should be found somewhere on the foyer level.
Why the big hurry?
If Dr. Carroll is not extracted tonight, Datadyne will put him through mind conditioning. We'll lose our best chance of finding out what Datadyne are up to.
Are they all expendable?
Don't joke. You have to be careful, Joanna. Code keys will only operate while the owner is alive. If you kill them, the key is useless. Armed guards are a different matter, of course.
What's the target location?
Work your way down the building to the ground level. Dr. Carroll will be in a research lab somewhere in the underground facility.
How will I recognize him?
We don't have an image record, so we can't find any official files. All we have is the name. Good luck, Perfect Dark.
All right, here we go. Where's the fucking patrolling guard? There we are. Take out that light, it's a little blinding. And in some ways, I almost wish this was a blind Let's Play. Because the very first time that I played this game, my dumbass did not read the briefing.
We're getting a positive reading. The internal comms hub is nearby.
Confirmed.
And the only thing that I heard in that opening cutscene was, if you kill them, the key is useless. So I went through this, or attempted to go through this entire stage, completely melee. And it did not turn out well. And also, the other thing that kind of hindered me on that is, you don't have to pick up Cassandra's necklace when you're playing on Agent. But we'll just go ahead and get that now. Unlock the door, and trick or treat.
Who are you, and what are you doing here?
Look out! She's got a gun!
You won't shoot me, foolish child.
No, but I will put you to sleep. And speaking of sleep, if you all want to get a restful night's sleep, you'll want a mattress from today's sponsor, Helix Sleep. Well, wouldn't that be great if I actually had sponsors and could just launch into a segue like that? I wonder if I should make that a thing, going through the rest of this Let's Play, is just doing parody advertisements like streamers and podcasters do, but, considering that I don't actually have sponsors and I'm using real company names, I think there might be some legal implications to that. So best not to chance it. Data Dawn guards sure do enjoy eating lead. I mean, it is part of a balanced breakfast, so it's all well and good. Make sure I collect all the ammo.
Cover me.
I'm not doing a very good job of that right now. Nice headshot. Almost like we're back in top form here.
Intruder alert!
Alright, now, did the main security guard see me anywhere? He certainly did. Hello?
Yes, yes, I agree. Personality is expendable in this case. No, I can start the process from my office terminal and delete the necessary files at the same time. I'll begin at once. Goodbye.
Help! Intruder! Security, help me!
Can you not see that security's dead?
I've got a password problem, and you're the man to help me with it.
But don't shoot! Don't shoot!
This company's security is about as effective as. I'm gonna have to censor that. Oh, I'm gonna have to censor that. That. Don't get me wrong, y'all. I like a dark joke. Jimmy Carr is one of my favorite comedians, but. My ass will get canceled for that. I'm gonna have to censor that. Come on, get the lead out of your ass, dude. I got places to be. Move it, move it, move it.
I'm logging on now. Right, I'm in.
And you can just go ahead and take a nap as well. Been working too much overtime. You earned it. File downloaded. Faster download speeds than my shitty Spectrum internet, that's for sure. see which one gets here first. There we go. Now, just make sure I don't get seen by the goon squad. The goon squad are those two guys over the railing. I don't care if the rest of them see me. I'm gonna have to get spotted eventually. Oh, nope, one more. Thought that was it.
The other hub's got to be in the security room.
Yes, yes, we know, Joanna. Don't talk to yourself, it's not a good look.
We've got a contact!
And that takes care of that. Second mine placed. Last of the ammunition collected. Here we go.
Basement elevator must be around there somewhere.
Come on. Indeed.
Take us out!
Oh! There's always one trying to hide. Mission complete. And in a little over 7 minutes, not too bad. Certainly not world record pace, but we're improving. Yes, yes, I know this isn't a speed run, shut up. And I think we're gonna go ahead and not take too long on the outro because I wanna get a couple more of these recorded today before I go have dinner. So we have officially infiltrated Datadyne, and next time we will fight our way through the laboratory and locate the elusive Dr. Carroll. Until then, if you enjoyed this video, please be sure to like, share, and subscribe. Also, hit the links in the description, follow me on Facebook and Twitter, and do please consider supporting this channel on Patreon. And until I see you all again, this is Lance Cassidy, signing off.